All right, let's get started. My name is Brett Harward. This is Joelle Martin. We have had the great opportunity of being with your loved ones and with the people that were in the Awakenings training this week. And it's been a fabulous week, absolutely fantastic week. So we'd like to introduce, first of all, the staff. So the staff this week was Doug and Karis. And Nina. Scott and Jason. Gary and Ryan. Tyler, Ron, and Casey. Brooke and Andrea. Weston and Eric.
Sure. for coming out tonight and introduce you to 225. This may seem a little strange to you that we all have your backs to you guys. There's a purpose to this. This first training, it's called the Awakenings. But as we stand here before you like this right now, this represents what we were before we came here, and that was asleep. But if you listen to what these people have to share with you, it represents who they are now and what they awoke to through this training. And so now I'm going to take my place in line. And this beautiful individual right here will start and letting us know what it is that she awoke to, and we will share with you what we all awoke to.
Forgiveness. Self-love.
Trust.
Yes.
Authentication.
Intimacy.
Compassion.
Joy.
Power!
Living.
Self-worth.
Power.
Courage.
Creativity.
Self-worth.
Yay!
Freedom!
Courage.
Yeah!
Honest.
Confident. Energy!
Yeah!
Power! Enlightenment.
Confidence.
Passion. Freedom.
Courage.
Self-worthiness.
Yeah!
Love.
Wow.
I'm awake. Power. Joy.
Yeah! Joy!
Courage.
Courage.
Worthiness.
Yeah! Woo!
Integrity.
Rebirth.
Yeah! Inspired.
Power. Self-worth.
Yeah!
Many of us would make comments referring to we, making us whole. And we were corrected real fast. It's I. I think that I can speak for we now. And in doing so, I kind of wrote something for... I'm a poet, I love to write poetry. And this is our promise to ourselves. We're willing to have courage. It takes strength to be certain. It takes courage to have doubts. It takes strength to fit in. It takes courage to stand out. It takes strength to share a friend's pain. It takes courage to feel your pain. It takes strength to hide your own pain. It takes courage to show it. It takes strength to stand guard. It takes courage to let your guard down. It takes strength to conquer. It takes courage to surrender. It takes strength to stand alone. It takes courage to lean on a friend. It takes strength to love. It takes courage to be loved. It takes strength to survive, and it takes courage to actually live. May we find strength to have the courage to live the life we know we want and deserve.
Not. I'm watching you.
Answer first.
Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now
I've been asked to share my story.
My body.
Freedom's a powerful word. It's the opposite of fear. And I've found that this week, these 4 days have allowed me to jump away from my fears, my past, and truly feel free. I'm not afraid of you.
Yeah.
I'm not afraid to cry. I'm not afraid to stand in front of you and
sing.
And sing. Or attempt to sing. I found more love in my life. And I can't thank my angels enough who saw the path I was on. Brett, thank you. My other angel's in Florida. She sent her daughter tonight. Thank you all for being here and for supporting us, for making it possible for us to be here. One thing I'm not afraid of anymore: showing my wife public affection.
I can't really yell anymore. Which my kids and my husband are grateful for. And I can thank the beautiful song of the Unreachable Star for this. I screamed a lot. I cheered my teammates on. Standing behind me is my family. Standing in front of me are my friends. I thought I came here to save America. I came here to save myself. I am not afraid to be a woman that cries, a woman that loves, and a woman that trusts. I am not afraid to be the woman that my parents wanted me to be. I'm not afraid to parent my children the way I want them to be. We've been through an incredible path. My story even pales to so many behind me. But I swear to you, when I see you again, it's going to be a greater life. And we can pass it on. I love my family. I love my friends. Thank you for coming here and honoring us. This has been tough.
Each and every one of you, because I love each and every one of you. Thank you so much for your support. I was a fast-moving locomotive on a one-way track to destruction, self-destruction, and this was a little over 4 years ago, and then I beat that. I beat alcohol and drugs. I beat the addiction. And fortunately and unfortunately, I came back from Iraq with 3 years and 9 months sober, and somehow, just overnight, I turned back into that same man, only sober this time. And I hit that one-way track so fast and so hard. And all I could think of myself was that I was a monster, and I was very uncomfortable in my own skin. I did not want to look at myself in the mirror for the man who I had become. And I knew that was no way to live. But throughout my year out there, I had one young man that did this program a little over 2 years ago. And I saw something in him that I saw in the sober people. And I wanted that. I wanted that peace. I wanted that serenity. And I wanted it so bad, but I was so afraid when I got home of how I was going to accomplish that. So this right here, leaving this angry, cold, distant, unemotional man behind, was the second hardest thing that I've had to do in my life. And I have been through a lot of pain. I mean, we all have our stories, right? Our illustrations. I won't go there with that one, Brett. There's innocent people in this crowd. But I want to thank everybody in my group too, and me, because this is one person now that I've grown to love. And this morning was literally the first time that I was able to look in the mirror and see that I am able to separate that angry, cold man that I had become, and I can now be me once again. And that is the loving, passionate, caring, generous,
self-fulfilled man that I am today, and I want to continue to be through part two, through part three, and forever. I'm taking this to the grave with me. And to my soldier, I love you, man. My extended family, thanks for being here. I love you guys too. But reality, I love number one.
Yes.
So screw all of you, I love number one. No, but really, I love each and every one of you. Thank you guys so much. And I've been medically discharged from the military, the army. So I also had to leave that part of me behind. I'm no longer a soldier, but I still am a soldier at heart. So I salute every one of you. I love you. Thank you for your service, for those of us who serve.
Right now, I'd like to give some recognition to my angels, who, at this point now, have saved me twice. I went into foster care a few years back, and I didn't have the greatest upbringing with my mother. And, Corinne Jean, please stand up. Please. They took me into their home, and they took a chance on me. And I thank them from the bottom of my heart. And for a while, I lost my way after I moved out. And coming here helped me find my way again. My aunt, she kept talking to me about coming to this program, telling me she wanted me to do it. She thought it'd be good for me. I didn't believe her. I finally took a chance. And thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
My word was courage, and when I came here, I couldn't look anybody in the face, not because I was afraid of them, but because I was so sad and depressed that my head was perpetually down and I was like this. And so people shared and I learned that I was perceived as an old lady, and that was troubling. I must admit that was troubling. But like so many people in my new family, I was the product of a dysfunctional alcoholic family, and my life was filled with coldness and pain and rejection and abandonment. And I self-medicated with food and weighed 312 pounds. So I arranged for a life transformation and lost 160 pounds. But I was still not happy, because I still felt the cold and rejection. And I had all the material things that you could want. I had financial security, and I had lots of female friends, because I didn't ever have trouble relating to women. It was just men. So I met a trainer some time ago, and didn't, you know, I'd hear what she said, but I was kind of rejected. And yet every time life got a little rocky for me, Annalie came back into my radar. The universe, boy, has more imagination than we do. And the universe sent Annalie to me again just when I was feeling desperate. So I came here and I brought my pain and my sadness and my rejection and my abandonment with me. And I cried and I beat that chair and I sang. I cried.
I cried and cried and cried and cried, and I launched my mother off into wherever she is. That's doubtful. It's highly doubtful. And I have a new, warm, loving, forgiving, nurturing, wonderful family. And I have found peace and happiness and contentment. And if there are people in the audience who have not done the program, there aren't words to urge you strongly enough. And for Annalie, wherever she's over there, in my heart, she's adopted. And so now I have a mother who, and I have a new family that I love and will never forget. And thank you all, Joelle and Brett and all the staff and everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah.